Today I thought we could explore the idea of the ego, the mind, and consider the possibility that maybe we are more than just who we think we are. Let's begin with a smoke cleanse. For those of you who are curious, my ethnic background is Kazakh, and before we subscribed to a religion, we were shamanic people, and we still have some of these traditions to this day. One of them is doing smoke cleanses, and we like to use cedar, which we call arsha. But I don't have a lot left, and my garden sage is getting super dry, so I thought we could use this instead today. This is sage that I grew in my garden, and it's more than ready to be used. Allow yourself to just observe the smoke as it fills your aura, cleanses your aura, and takes away any murkiness from your energetic field. Allow it to cleanse you of all that you no longer. Allow everything to go. Release what isn't serving you in this moment. Release. Let it go. You can release these unhelpful thoughts, emotions, stories, projections. You can center yourself. And that's the goal today, to center ourselves. We can define who we really are. So that we can familiarize ourselves a truer aspect of our inner reality in a world now I have these beautiful moonlight looking selenite crystals. They have this rounded shape that is great for giving massages. So I want you to visualize as I move these crystals around your aura, that you're receiving a light massage. Allow yourself to soften your muscles from the head all the way down to your feet. Beginning with the head, allow your scalp to soften, activating the crown chakra. Allow light in. This is where Reiki energy is received. And flows down into your being. Relax the scalp. Feel tingles at the very top of your head. Relax the neck. Relax the neck. Lengthening the neck. Loosen the jaw. Gently pressing into the shoulders. Pressing into the shoulders. To help you release any burden locked up here. Soften the muscles. Release. Breathe in and out. Good. Now allow your arms to relax. Soften the arms. Now allow your arm to relax. Soften the arms. Feel any excess energy, repressed energy, flow through your arms, out of your hands, fingertips. Feel that energy. Out of the hands and fingertips. Good. Now, take a couple more deep breaths, but this time with the belly. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Belly rises. And out. Breathe in. And out. Allow your legs to relax as well. I don't know about you, but sometimes I get jittery legs. And that's just excess energy built up. You're welcome to tense your legs for a moment and then release them. That can help and do wonders. Relax the muscles in your legs, becoming aware of your lower body. Notice your feet, relax the feet and toes. Feel the energy flow from the legs to the feet and out the toes. Release this excess energy. Your entire body is relaxing now. And what's great is that when you relax the body, you can relax the mind. When the body is free of tension, the mind is free of stress. And this is going to help us gain clarity around today's subject. Let's create space in the mind. Let's create space in the mind. Allow your breathing to deepen. And when you do this, create space in the mind. Oftentimes, we're led to believe that because we think we are, there's that famous quote by a philosopher, I think it's Descartes, "I think, therefore I am." But if you really think about it, true. It cannot be true. Because there are moments when you don't think. We are not slaves to our thoughts. Our thoughts come and always remain. So our ability to think cannot define us. There is an element to our experience deeper than thinking, reasoning, and contemplating. You are, therefore you think. I am. Therefore, I think. Your consciousness comes before all else. You are conscious. You are aware. Being aware, and the awareness itself is more you. Than your thoughts and emotions. I think it's healthy to have an ego, but it must be integrated. And we integrate it by accepting it, but also by combining its ability or resourcefulness with the wisdom awareness and pure consciousness, this sacred combination is what makes us so powerful as a species. And exhale. Breathe in. And exhale. Breathe in. Exhale. I'm going to pull some cards and see what the deck has to say about this topic, to see what our energy has invited into this conversation. Let me just show you all the cards that we got. The first card is the Hermit. And then we have the Page of Cups. Then we have the Knight of Swords. Then we have Temperance. And I also feel called to include the card that was at the bottom of the deck, which is the Ten of Swords. I think these cards are perfect for what we are talking about. And I'm going to begin with the swords that we got. So we have the Knight of Swords here. As you can see, he's racing forward. There's fast motion forward, and he's ready to go into battle. There is a storm coming, but he's not afraid. You can see he's very determined for where he's going. He has his sword up and he's ready to fight. The horse, however, is a little scared. And what this represents to me is when we are so identified with the mind and the mind's story, we can quickly get ourselves into rabbit holes and make the wrong decision, make the wrong move, take the wrong step. The night represents the rational mind. The horse represents our instincts, the lower brain. And the horse can instinctually sense that this isn't the right thing to be doing. The horse represents our gut feeling. And so it shows a bit of disconnect. When we are so in our heads, we get wrapped up in stories and don't actually listen to the gut feeling. And I think that's the reality for many people. We are quite disconnected from our intuition, instincts, and that deeper knowing. And in order to connect to that deeper knowing, of course, is that we have to go into this period of hermitage, of being the hermit in pure aloneness. This card represents connecting deep within to discover this light, which will then take you further in your path, which will help you move forward. So this is a card of retreat, tuning in, meditation, and self-discovery, which is, I think, the most important thing in the world. So if you are in this space right now, I invite you to consider moving into this space. It's always uncomfortable at first, which is why sometimes life will ask you to surrender and give up. So the suit of swords represent thinking, the element of air, communication, thoughts, mind. And when we get to the ten of swords, we reach a completion of that. As you can see, the Ten of Swords isn't that great. It's when we finally give up the mind, when we see its limits, how it's been keeping us unconscious, and surrender to defeat. When we give up the mind, we allow dawn to rise. So you can see in the back, the sun is about to rise. Dawn is coming. So he's not gonna remain defeated forever. Every end is a new beginning. And when you realize that mind identification cannot give you everything, rather it's keeping you unconscious, then you can welcome in a brighter, a different perspective and reality. So this is essential in any healing process, and what you achieve through that is beautiful. What you can learn essentially is to tap into your emotions. The Page of Cups represents innocence and openness about our feelings and emotions. He is very different from this man over here. this man would probably make fun of the Page of Cups, treat him like he doesn't know anything. But the truth is, we achieve this sort of innocence after the turmoil of the mind. The Page of Swords has a lot of wisdom that I think our modern society does not appreciate enough. But in order to heal and become fully integrated as human beings, our emotions are important. And I think this card really calls for that. Additionally, we must find a way to walk the middle path. The Temperance card always shows up for me when I am in a deep, balanced state of mindfulness, of meditation. And I think the reason for that is because the image illustrates the energy of the middle path. See how she's pouring water from one cup to the other. And now she has one foot in the water and one foot on the ground. She's illustrating balance. And also there is symmetry between the two angel wings. The mind ceases to be when we find balance between polarities. And this is a whole nother topic on its own. Let me know if you'd like me to talk about it. But essentially, when we can give up identification and the need to cling to this or that, we can finally rest in the middle and balance. And that's where the mind quiets, where we begin to feel a sense of stillness and calm. And that's what this card represents. That's meditation. I hope this tarot reading was able to inspire some things within you, teach you something. Again, these were the cards. This healing light and love. Allow it to flow through your crown all the way down into your heart, amplifying the energy, expanding it into the rest of your being. Rest in this energy. So that you replenish, rejuvenate your body, mind, and soul. Going to play. play the singing bowl. Allow yourself to just relax and listen to the sound. Allow the sound to entrain your mind into a serene, relaxed space. Allow the sound to carry the sound.